Armenian Diaspora, Wikipedia article audio. The Armenian diaspora refers to the communities of Armenians outside the Republic of Armenia and other locations where Armenians are considered an indigenous population. Since antiquity, Armenians have established communities in many regions throughout the world. However, the modern Armenian diaspora was largely formed as a result of the Armenian Genocide of 1915, when the Armenians living in their ancestral homeland in eastern Turkey, known as Western Armenia to Armenians, were systematically exterminated by the Ottoman government. In Armenian, the diaspora is referred to as Spyurk, spelled in classical orthography and in reformed orthography. In the past, the word Gagut was used mostly to refer to the Armenian communities outside the Armenian homeland. It is borrowed from the Aramaic cognate of Hebrew Galu. Terminology. History. The Armenian diaspora has been present for over 1700 years. The modern Armenian diaspora was formed largely after World War I as a result of the Armenian Genocide. According to Randall Hansen, both in the past and today, the Armenian communities around the world have developed in significantly different ways within the constraints and opportunities found in varied host cultures and countries. After the fall of the Ottoman Empire, Turkish nationalists led by Mustafa Kemal Atatürk took the region of Western Armenia. As a result of the Armenian Genocide, Armenians were forced to flee to different parts of the world and created new Armenian communities far from their native land. Through marriage and procreation, the number of Armenians in the diaspora who trace their lineage to those Armenians who survived and fled Western Armenia is now several million. Since the breakup of the Soviet Union, approximately 1 million Armenians have joined the diaspora largely as a result of difficult economic conditions in Armenia. Civan Tabibian, an Armenian scholar and former diplomat in Armenia, said, "Armenians are not place-bound, but are intensely place-conscious." In the 4th century, Armenian communities already existed outside of Greater Armenia. Diasporic Armenian communities emerged in the Sassanid and Persian empires, and also to defend eastern and northern borders of the Byzantine Empire. In order to populate the less populated areas of Byzantium, Armenians were relocated to those regions. Some Armenians converted to Greek Orthodoxy while retaining Armenian as their language, whereas others stubbornly clung on to remain in the Armenian Church despite pressure from official authorities. A growing number of Armenians voluntarily migrated or were compelled to move to Cilicia during the course of the 11th and 12th centuries. After the fall of the kingdom to the Mamluks and loss of Armenian statehood in 1375, up to 150,000 went to Cyprus, the Balkans, and Italy. Although an Armenian diaspora existed during antiquity and the Middle Ages, it grew in size due to emigration from the Ottoman Empire, Iran, Russia, and the Caucasus. The Armenian diaspora is divided into two communities, those from Ottoman Armenia and those who are from the former Soviet Union, the Independent Republic of Armenia and Iran. Armenians of the modern Republic of Turkey do not consider themselves as part of the Armenian diaspora, since they believe that they continue residing in their historical homeland. Distribution. The Armenian diaspora grew considerably during and after the First World War due to dissolution of the Ottoman Empire. Although many Armenians perished during the Armenian Genocide, some of the Armenians managed to escape and established themselves in various parts of the world. Today, the Armenian diaspora refers to communities of Armenians living outside the Republic of Armenia and the Republic of Artsakh, since these regions form part of Armenians' indigenous homeland. The total Armenian population living worldwide is estimated to be 11 million. Population by country. Of those, approximately 3 million live in Armenia, 130,000 in the de facto independent Nagorno-Karabakh and 120,000 in the region of Javakh in neighboring Georgia. This leaves approximately 7 million in diaspora. Less than one-third of the world's Armenian population lives in Armenia. Their pre-World War I population area was 6 times larger than that of present-day Armenia, including the eastern regions of Turkey, northern part of Iran, southern part of Georgia, Artsakh, and Nakhichevan regions of Azerbaijan. The table below lists countries and territories where at least a few Armenians live, with their number according to official data and estimates by various organizations and media. Estimates may vary greatly, because no reliable data are available for some countries. In France, Syria, Iran, Lebanon, Germany, and many other countries, ethnicity was never enumerated during population censuses, and it is virtually impossible to determine the actual number of Armenians living there. Data on people of foreign origin is available for most European Union countries, but doesn't present the whole picture and can hardly be taken as a source for the number of Armenians, because in many countries, most prominently France, most Armenians aren't from the Republic of Armenia and they don't have any legal connection with their ancestral homeland. Also, not all Armenian citizens and people born in Armenia are ethnic Armenians, but the overwhelming majority of them are, as about 97.9% of the country's population is Armenian. For other countries, such as Russia, the official number of Armenians is believed, by many, to have been underrated, because many migrant workers live in the country. Not listed, Armenians in Myanmar, Armenians in Bahrain, Armenians in Qatar, Armenians in Sudan. 1. Russia is a transcontinental country in Eastern Europe and Northern Asia. The vast majority of its population lives in European Russia, therefore Russia as a whole is included as a European country here. 2. Turkey is a transcontinental country in the Middle East and Southeast Europe. It has a small part of its territory in Southeast Europe called Turkish Thrace. 3. Armenia, Azerbaijan, and Georgia are transcontinental countries. Both have a small part of their territories in the European part of the Caucasus. 4. Kazakhstan is a transcontinental country. It has a small part of its territories located west of the Urals in Eastern Europe. 5. Cyprus is entirely in Southwest Asia, but has socio-political and historical connections with Europe.